Now, this video here provides an introduction to the computation of MLE standard errors. Now, the MLE estimate in a finite sample is a random variable. One wants to know how certain can one be that the MLE estimate coincides with the population parameter. Now, let's take an extreme case. If the log likelihood function was a horizontal function in theta, then there would be an infinite amount of theta values that all provide the same maximal likelihood. Hence, any value you picked would be correct, but also wrong, as there are an infinite amount of different theta values that are as good in terms of the likelihood value. Therefore, the more curved the log likelihood function around the MLE estimate of theta, the higher the estimation precision and the lower the uncertainty that we have that the MLE that we found might be far off from the population value. Now, the Hessian matrix, defined as the second derivative of the log likelihood function with regard to theta, it captures the second derivative of the log likelihood function and therefore the curvature of that function. Hence, the more curvature, the larger the Hessian, and the smaller the inverse of the Hessian, and therefore the smaller the standard error of the maximum likelihood estimate for theta. Now next, I want to show you how to compute the MLE standard error. The MLE standard error coincides with the square root of the variance of the MLE estimator theta hat ML. Now the variance of theta hat ML coincides with the inverse of the Fisher information matrix. We write that as follows, where I is the information matrix. In most cases, you will have to calculate the information matrix numerically. You can either compute a sequence of second derivatives or a sequence of first derivatives. For a maximization problem, the ith-jth entry of the information matrix equals the following expression. So it highlights you can either really take the product of Jacobian terms or you take the second derivative. Now in a separate video, I'm verifying explicitly that the last equality sign holds. For now, notice very importantly, for a minimization problem, you multiply the above expression by minus one. Now the standard error of the vector valued estimator theta hat ML coincides with the square root of the diagonal elements of the variance of theta ML. In most applications that you come across, you won't be able to compute the expectation explicitly. In that case, you compute what is called the observed Fisher information matrix, which for a maximization problem reads as follows. And note here that the log of L is the sum across time of ln LT.
Got feedback? We would love to hear it. Please drop us a line. And if you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel.